Hey everyone, Raven here. And today, the Metheus puzzle was solved. I spent a long time with a few of my friends, Chewy Candy, Tonic, and a bunch of people in my Discord trying to solve this puzzle yesterday. We got close. We were right about some things. We were still off by some stuff, so we didn't solve it first. But it was solved today, and I'm going to try my best to explain how to do this. If after this video you still have no clue how to do it, maybe someone in my comment section could help, or just join my Discord, and I'm sure someone there could help. If not other people, I sure can at some point. So I'll leave the link to that in the description, and to all the other links that are needed for this video. I uploaded the first part of this video yesterday, the one to get the tragic torch, which is needed for this. So if you don't have the torch yet, well, actually, even if you got the torch the first time from when the first puzzle came out a long time ago, go back and redo it anyways, because you get the same skin, and one would be called Timeless and the other one would be considered a loyal tier. So I recommend doing that. It'd be cool having both. I unfortunately only have one. I'm happy to have it, because I missed out on the puzzle before. So let me try and explain this the best I can. It's kind of confusing. But all right, so let's just jump into this. I'll try my best, guys. All right, so first of all, this puzzle requires two people to complete. For the whole puzzle, you need two people. So I consider this puzzle one. For puzzle one, it's really easy. What you do is both take a picture of your current board. So you both have a different set of yellow and black symbols. So once you decide which color you want to do, so if you want to do yellow symbols, you type in his yellow symbols, and he'll type in your black symbols, or vice versa. Once that was done, all should be lit, and the first puzzle is over. After you do that, the right side should open up, and you'll be linked to your partner, who you did the first puzzle with. Then you guys move on to the second board, puzzle, whatever you call it. I'm calling it puzzle. And all right, this one I think is gonna be a little hard for me to explain. Someone told me it was like a game called Mastermind. So once again, one of you will have these squares that I have, and the other one will have these black symbols. I think these are called rune symbols, and the other one are called squares, I think. Let's just go with that. Rune symbols and square symbols. And these six boxes down here, I consider this one one, this one two, this one three, this one four, this one five, this one six. And this is exactly how I explained it to my buddy Tonic and Chewy when they were doing it. And I think that helped them out a lot. I think that's the way Cryinson explained it to me. Someone explained it to me like that. I'm just going to explain it that way because I feel like that's the best way I could re-explain it to someone. So once you have your partner's picture, I would recommend putting them in the same order as they are in the image. So once you both do that, then go from there. Normally when we first put them down, we would hit the button in the middle to see if any are in the correct position. And if we get a yellow dot, then we know one is in the correct order. But on the safe side, I would be sure to do the countdown method once again when clicking the button in the middle, just to make sure. Like I said, I'm not sure if that matters, but to be safe, I would do it. Remember that you want to communicate with your partner. Don't make a move without the other person knowing what you're doing, because you have to move your pieces together. The only exception would be is you're going to have double pieces. So let's, for example, say my one and three are both the same symbol. His what might not be. So if he decides he wanna switch his one and three, you wouldn't have to because yours are the same. So that's gonna be a factor in this as well. And then once it checks, if any of those are in the right position, a yellow light will light up for each one you have correct. So it's pretty much a trial and error. Basically put them on the right places where they belong, so until all six dots are glowing, and then you're done. Once you get them all matched up, you have the correct order. And I have this list I'll put in the description that I used.
So after this puzzle, you have to go find a chest. And before I actually get to where the chest is, the chest has six slots. So for this picture, for example, so you would decode these with the link in the description, which I showed you. So for example, this image means walking cane. And then on my partner's, his means one. So we need one walking cane, and we would put it in slot one in the chest. And then this image means crow. So once again, this means one, so we need one live crow. And that would go in slot two of the chest. And then slot three is petals. And this, in his slot three, this means eight. So we need eight petals in slot three of the chest. And then just so on.
Like I said, if you need any more help after that, just let me know. Maybe someone can help you in this video, or my Discord. I'm sure someone could help you there, if not myself. I've been on there a lot lately, so I'm gonna try and get on there a little bit every day, so I could definitely help some people out if you have more questions after this video. Okay, so then from there,
you both gotta go in a game. We started a new world. I'm not sure if that's required, but to be on the safe side, that's what we did. I also leave a command in the description that could teleport you directly to where the chest is at, which would make things easier. We also, to save time, we just spawn the items that we needed in. You could just look up, or I could leave a command page for you guys to look at. I teleport myself there. I know there's a command to teleport people. I offhand do not know it. But we just used a lazy deserter to get for him to teleport to me, which just took a few seconds anyways. If you put the items in the wrong order, they will shoot out of the chest. Or if you have the wrong amount in that slot, it'll also shoot out of the chest. So make sure you decipher those correctly, and then the items in the chest be gone. You get a note, and then just log out of the world on the start screen. You get your presents, and then once you go back to the puzzle, you notice the background's different. You see the portal in the background. And if you click on that, you get a video. I'm not going to show that part. I'll put a link to the video in the description in case you want to go watch that. It does show Charlie in it. But that's it for this. This was definitely hard for me to explain. I hope someone can make sense of what I was talking about. Like I said before, if you still have trouble with it, just come to my Discord or let me know in the comments and I can try and explain it a little better. I hope this video definitely helped you out though. And I'll see you guys next time.